Hello again. Let's color some beginner cute animal with sketchbook. I am using the desktop version. It's a little bit different than the one you can use on your telephone or your tablet, but all the options are there. But because I do not have it, I can't explain you where to find it, but believe me, it is there. You need some figuring out, but I think you will find your way. But let's continue with this one. I have chosen a simple picture. I do not want it to be too complicated. There is some fur in it and some metal. Okay, let's see. We are always starting with clicking on this. Here we are going to enter our layer thingy. And let's click this away. Here you can see this is your first layer. This is what you are looking at, this beautiful foxy animal. And let's go ahead. The first thing I always do is click on a new layer and set it to color. And then I'm going to find my colors. You can find them over here at this thing here, and here we have all our colors. Here you can extract colors from a page if you want. You can make your own color palette, and these are the ones I already have. I always like to work with my Copic colors. I like them a lot, but I have lots more. But let's focus on this. When I'm starting this, I try to figure out what do I want. I want it to look a little bit vintage, and well, then you are mostly stuck to the greens and the browns, and I want the animal to look brownies. So in this case I am going for a brown color. And I'm going to click on the flood fill bucket and then click on the animal, and now we see he has got one color. Now I am going to add on another layer, and then I'm going to go for overlay. You have lots of different blending modes. You can try them all because they are easy to get rid of. So you can just see what's going to happen. But overlay is a nice one. And I want to add some darker brown to it. And I'm going to click on it again. And now we see some difference in the color. And here we have this blue thing here. You can go up and down and adjust your color. I never use it all the way up to 100 because I think it's too much color. I will go a little bit below, and well, I think this looks nice. This is a good way to start coloring what you want. So we have done that, and we are going to click on a new layer. And I'm going to set it to color, and I'm going to choose my tool. If you click on your brush palette, you find, and then you click on those three dots here, you enter your brush library, and there you have a lot and lot of things. There is a special brush palette for fur. I have never used it before, because I'm always very lazy, and well, I always go for the airbrush because that works. But I was told that the brush palette is looking really well. The fur brushes. You can see we have lots of fur brushes. This is a wavy fur. That's not what he has. He has short fur, short sparse fur, thick fur wisp and straight fur. Lots and lots of wiry fur clump, long wiry fur. I think we are going for the straight fur. I think that's nice. So let's see what is going to happen. If you click on it, you enter your options. You can also choose your blending mode. I'm going to set it to color also, and I've set it to color here. You have your size. You can see what's happening when I do this. Smaller stripes, larger stripes, and the opacity is how much coverage you're going to get. So opacity mostly around 80, and the darker the colors later on, I sometimes go lighter, but you can play with it. So that's also with the size. Let's see, what are we going to do? You can see already those darker colors, but I want to add on a little bit more of those dark tones. So I'm going to go for I think this brown will look pretty. Let's enlarge him. This is your enlarge tool. You can swear it up and down. You can flip it around. If you scroll on your mouse, you can get it larger, and you can play around. So always enlarge. It's so much easier, really. So let's see what is going to happen with our brush. I have to say, you can also do it with airbrush. It's possible. I never have done this before. So let's see. You are the first ones I show this. But my good friend and groupmate Wendy assured me that these are pretty good. Because we use the first two layers, it's already in brown. So most of the color is already there. I think you can see if you are coloring over the dark and the white areas, the white is still going to stay relatively light, and the dark areas are really getting a lot darker. So it's very easy to get some shading in your coloring. And basically this brush makes little lines, so use it in the same way the hair grows. That makes sense. Do not do this, but let it flow in the area the hair grows. And I have to say, I actually like this brush. Sometimes you must take your time on a blank piece of page and just find out what every brush does. It has so many options, but most of the time I use the airbrush. It's easy and fast for a lot of things. So, but yeah, you can play a little bit with it, and you can also play with the blending modes. But for now, let's see what's going to happen if we are going to use this. If you have large areas, don't be afraid and just enlarge it. It's faster. But be aware that you do not go over the edges. So keep an eye on what you are doing. And if you think it's getting too big for the area I am on, then you adjust your size. I don't know if you see it, but if I go over the white, there is nothing much to see. So in this case, it's easy. If the background was darker, then we would actually add on some color. So white areas, it's complicated to get some color, and on the darker ones, it's really easy to get an extra hint of color. So it's basically as with pencils. The technique behind it is almost the same. So you can play with it. And as you can see, we haven't done so much, and it actually looks really good. I'm going to achieve here also a large contrast between black and white, between dark and light. That's what a coloring makes a coloring really nice. Always go for the contrast, and then it will be amazing. So, I like the fur brush so far, but also there is a hair brush, lots of brushes. So, for me, this is a new one, but if you have chosen one, it's all basically the same. Let's go to his ears. And just play with it. But the layers are very important. Try to give every color their own layer. If you have finished one and you do not like it, you can throw it away. If you mix every part of your coloring together, a piece of the head, a piece of the clothes, a piece of the fur, and then you make a mistake, then you have to throw away half of your coloring. So try to be secure in your layering. I know when you are doing this the first time, it's a little bit confusing, and like me, I am a really chaotic person, so I forget to do that lots and lots of times. But for me, it's not such a big problem anymore, because most of the time it simply works. But in the past, it was not the case. Coloring digital is basically just trying to see what is going to happen. So if you want to do this, it's easy just to follow my instructions and do the same thing. If you want, I have my own Facebook group, Crayon World Coloring and Dream World Coloring. I have my own coloring bookshop. So does my friend Corrie de Vries. She owns Crayon World Coloring, and together we have a fun and I think a lovely Facebook group with some other members who are very creative and love to color, and yeah, we love to show you lots of tricks. So this page I made myself. It's a Dreamworld page. It's a steampunk adorable creature. So if you want to try, you can always send me a message, and I love to give you this page. Or you can go to Etsy and you get the entire book. That's also possible. It's a fun book, so why not? Let's go back to the layers. I think this one is a nice one. For this, it is okay. Let's add another layer. Set it to color again. And we are going to add on a different color. I want it to be a little bit more... shall we use... I think this is nice, a little bit more light. Let's see what is going to happen if we are going to use it. Let's start the ear now. Is it working to add on some color? Yes, you see, we are adding on a lighter color. And I think that's nice. Let's enlarge it a little bit, blend it over it. Like I said, you could easily do this with your airbrush. But I have to say, using the fur brush makes it look a little more delicate. So I love the effect it gives. So yeah, happy with it. I think that's a very pretty ear. Let's go to the other one. I have chosen a not so complicated picture because, well, I see some people still finding it hard to do so. That's why I'm offering, if you want, this free page so you can try it yourself and do the exact same thing. That's the way I learned it, because I really didn't understand one single bit of it. One of my group members, Nanou Lesuis, I think if you are watching us on Facebook, you've seen her wonderful colorings. So she was patient enough to teach me how to do it. And I didn't understand for one single bit, but after I simply said and done and did what she told me, well, it made sense, and now I know how to do it, and I like it. And I see more and more people who are starting to do it. It's an easy way. You can do it everywhere. You can do it on holiday, you can do it when you are going to your work and you go by bus or train or well, you can do it. And it does not take up so much time if you use a not too complicated picture, so it's really fun to do, I think. I see now that I am coloring away most of my red color. It's not what I want, but I will show you a trick later on how to get that perfect again. I'm going to show you a neat little trick. So first I am filling it up, those colors. And okay, let's get some of the red back, because this is a waste. Okay, let's see. We have taken away too much of the red. What can we do about it? We are going back to this thing, and we are simply going to lower down the level, the thing, I do not know the English word. Let's see how it looks when we enlarge it. Yes, you see, now we have mixed those colors together. I can take it all the way out. You see, now it's completely red again. I can get it back to a way I think it's nice. Now it's a bit reddish and also a bit any other color, so I think for now it is kind of pretty. You can also say, maybe we can do this extra. You can go to this and you can duplicate your layer. Now it is a little bit more darker than it was before. That's also possible, so let's see what is pretty. Somewhere halfway, I think. Yeah. Do you agree? I think so. I hope so. I'm going to add on another layer. It's complicated to see now, because well, everything is still brownish. So let's change that. What kind of jacket would you want to wear? Let's keep it in a vintage steampunk style and give him a green jacket, not too bright, a little bit in these colors. I'm going for the dark color, and let's color his jacket, and let's see what's going to happen. You can see here also it does not stick on the lighter parts and a little bit more on the darker parts, so it looks already good in one layer. You can play a little bit with it, just like with color pencils, to make it more interesting. We're going to do that later on, and then it will be prettier than it is now. But you can also go for the fast way, and oh yeah, you can get really, really lovely results. Some people think you press one button with digital coloring and voila, your coloring is done. That's not the case. You really have to put some effort to it, and then it will be pretty. I do not know if I told you, I am coloring with a Wacom tablet. Then you have a real pencil that works with a tablet. The name says it already. It's just like coloring with a coloring pencil. You can do it with your mouse, but it's way more complicated. You have drawing pads in lots of different prices, from about 40 euros until over 8,000. I am using a Wacom 1. It's a really cheap tablet. I use the medium size. It was under 50 euros, and I have to say it simply works perfect. So if you want to try, it does not have to cost a lot. You can first try it and see if it's something you like. And I'm using the Sketchbook program. I have the Pro. It's not an expensive program, but the Pro has some extra colors, and I like that. It has some more options, and for the less amount of money this program costs, I think it's really, really worth it. But you can first try it with the free version, and you will get a long way with that also. So you can try it first with the free version and your mouse, and simply look if you think it's something for me. And just try to do what I do. I always look very carefully if I see brown pieces shimmering through. I do not want that. I want it to be nice and evenly green. So you can adjust the size. In smaller areas you can turn it down, and on larger areas you can enlarge it a little bit, and then you can go and do it a little bit faster and just try to cover it up. I don't know if you hear, but I hear my son, he's gaming, and by the sound of it I think he is winning. So if you hear something, it's my over enthusiastic son. He's having fun. Okay. If you do this more often, then you get used to this tablet and it becomes very easy to do this. One of the upsides is I know now, because of my coloring bookshop, I know a lot of customers, and I know a lot of stories behind everyone, and a lot of colorists have physical issues, and it's sometimes very complicated for them to sit at the table and to color with normal pencils. Lots of them did that in the past, but they can't do it anymore, and they are sometimes getting bullied because they color digital and they do not get likes, or they get ignored, or even sometimes they get really nasty remarks, and I do not understand, because I know the stories behind so many people, and be careful with that, because lots of people simply can't color any other way. And besides that, if you buy a coloring book or a PDF coloring book, it's your book. You can color it any way you like. So it's all good, I think. It's just a different way. If you watch my YouTube site, you can see I am a big coloring pencil junkie. I really am. I love it. But lately I haven't got so much time, and for this I have a bit more, and I have to say I do like it a lot. It's simply different, but I do like it. So I hope more people will give it a try and see that it is just something else, and I hope they do not be intimidated by it. It's not necessary, I think. So okay, enough about that. We have colored the green thing. If you would think, yuck, the green is so ugly, I want to get it away, then you go back to this round thing. If you click on it, you see a lot of things opening. The plus is to create a new layer. You have a dustbin. You can name it. You can merge your layers. Wouldn't do that. If you merge them, there is no... You cannot erase one layer. That's a problem. Wouldn't do that. Naming sometimes is can be handy, but you can hide one, so you can simply see what is happening when you are going to take it away, but not throw it away. You can lock one, then you are making sure you can't throw it away or do something strange with it. You can duplicate your action. We did that already. You can also say, I am throwing it away. Now my green jacket is gone. I can also undo that by this. Now my green layer is back. So you can play with your undo buttons. So you can play with it the way you want. You can also hide it. Now it's also gone. If you want to see it again, you show it again. So sometimes when you are a bit further, it's very handy to see what is happening when you are going to do something. If you say, maybe I should make this a little bit darker, maybe it's prettier, you can do that. You can also do that at the end. It's all possible. Play a little bit with it. You can undo it. No problem there. Click on the last layer again. And we are going for color again. Again, here you have lots of blending layers. See what it does. The ones I use the most are the glow, the overlay and the color. And normal sometimes. That are the ones I am using the most. But just give it a try and see what happens. What is happening. So you can always throw it away when it is not pretty. So play with it. His head. Let's see. What shall we do? I do not want it to be green. I think that's not pretty. And I do not want to use all the colors in the box. So I'm going to go for black. I'm going to skip my brush. I see I was still coloring with the fur brush. You see you can also color close with your fur brush. Well, let's do it better. See, it's always chaos when I'm doing something. Let's see. I love to use a traditional airbrush. You have a soft and a hard. I use the soft. Set it to 80 again. Almost. Yep. That's a good one to start. And I am going to color this black. Getting something black is a little bit complicated. You have to do that in multiple steps. So just keep looking and you will see what is going to happen. It will get pretty. We have some very nice tricks later on, and that will actually make a lot of difference. I will enlarge it a little bit. Always do. You can see so much better. You cannot color details if you cannot see the finer and smaller parts. Go around those metal thingies and go around the clock. And go a little bit wider on the parts where you can do it, because it's faster and it looks more smooth. Otherwise you make it a little bit scribbly. Okay, make it smaller again. Go to the edges. Do not want to see brown anymore. That is ugly. Okay, No, I think that looks good. This part, in the middle, I want to use another color. I think it's metallish. Or maybe I will make it leather, I do not know. I have to think. Sometimes I have to think about it and then I just leave it alone and it will come to me. I always do the pieces first, which I am very sure of. I went here outside of the lines, so I got it away. It's always best if you sometimes put your pen off the Wacom tablet, because then you can erase smaller parts. That's easier. Otherwise you have to do so much over again. Nope, like this. Let's make it smaller. You see, the undo button just gets it away. It's so easy. Easier than with pencils. Then you have to do it good, because there is no, you can't do it again and do it over. Okay, fun thing, because we have used the brown layer, we already have some nice brown, I don't know how to call those things, but let's color them a little bit more. I have, oh, it's the wrong one. We have to set it to color. Saturation is not the right one. And I'm going to add on a little bit more of the color. If I think it's too dark, you can also, you see, lighten it up a little bit. If you think so, this is better, you can do that. I think that is prettier. You can play a little bit with it. You can adjust it here, but also there. So you can play so much with the color, and I think it's so really handy. Because of the brown color we already have, it's very easy to make it look good, because it basically was already finished. I went over the lines, did you see it? Yes, it's no good. So let's do that better. And this part. Okay. Let's correct the green, you see? There was some green on the things, I do not know how to name them. So that's pretty, I think. And what shall we do? I think we should make this letter also. I think that's really steampunky, so we are going to do that. Yeah. I'm going to show you later on a very easy way to do the metal parts. You also have chosen already a color, but it's very easy to get that steampunk effect. Of course, you're always free to use other colors, but I like to do steampunk in those vintage colors. I like it. Okay, now we have done this. That's pretty. Oh, watch it. If I do this, I always do the return button, because I probably click something I shouldn't do. You can only click on it when you have this thing on, then it is no problem. Otherwise you get a stain. I have chosen a new one. Let's color his nose. Let's give him some cuteness. Let's go for the pinkish red. Yes, let's make it a little bit cute and adorable. Some pinkiness around his nose. Doesn't that look really pretty? Yes, I think so. And we are going to make another layer. We are going to his eyes. Let's give him bright blue eyes. I think that will be very pretty. I want to combine it with some yellow. So I'm going to go for a bright yellow, and I'm going to do that on the areas here, and I'm going to go for another layer, then I can blend them in later on, and let's go for a beautiful blue, a bright one. Let's see what's going to happen. It's a fantasy drawing, so you can over exaggerate it a little bit. You can just go for a brighter color than you would normally do. I always love to do that, to play a little bit with the colors, just have some fun. It makes it more interesting. You can also say, let's make this glass blue. I always try to use some of the same colors in different places. So we have done that now here. I think that is nice, just a little different. And well, let's see, turn it. You see, you can play with it. Let's enlarge it and see what looks good. Maybe you can also see now the pieces we forgot a little bit. Go away thing. I always fight with the thing. It will never go away when I want to. No brown and anymore. Nope. You can also color the middle one. It makes it a little bit blacker and it gets away the brown. I think so. A little less is really nice. And what have we done now? Set it to another layer in color again. And let's see how he looks. Ah, pretty decent. Let's do something of his blouse. What shall we do? I want it to be a little bit creamish. We can do the same color. We can also use another color. Let's see, what do we have? This is the brown. We have a pinkish color. I also have a light bluish color, I think, somewhere. Do we have that? Yes. Let's go for the bluish one. I think that will be nice. Let's see what is going to happen when we are going to use that. How is it going to turn out? Oh, we set the color is still on normal. You see, if you color with normal, you get this. You color everything away. So, not good. Go back. We set it to color again. And now we can try. You can always tone it down now a little bit, so that you just get a hint of color and not all the way. Because I do not want it to look too blue. I want it to look really, really light. First, let's cover it up all the way. Try not to go over the fur again. I am always, when I'm filming a video, it's sometimes a little bit more complicated to not rush, if you know what I mean. I want to show it to you and do not want to take up too much of your time. So sometimes I make small mistakes that I do not make when I'm coloring all by myself. And I can get really lost in what I'm doing, because it is really relaxing. It really is. It's a smooth way of coloring and simply a fun thing to do. I'm paying attention. I do not want to see brown anymore. I do not want it. I think the light blue is pretty. You can experiment with colors so much better than with pencils, I think. And I noticed that I actually learned things by doing this. Now, when I'm coloring with pencils, I suddenly have got some other coloring ideas that I didn't have. So that is actually really fun. And Okay. Starting to look good. Make it a little bit bigger. I still see some brown. I think you do two probably. It shimmers a little bit through because I turn the opacity way down. So, okay. Yeah, almost done, I think. I don't know if you see it. I see some green parts I haven't done. If you see something, you can click on this thing, if your color finder, and then you can press the color you want. And then if you see a small problem and you finish what you are doing, just correct that piece you forgot, and then it's all good again. It's not pretty if you forget things, so I always try to look again and find those areas I messed up a little bit. So, how does he look now? I think he looks pretty good. Now we are going to do a nice trick. We're going back to the layers. We are going to set it to overlay again. Not color, but overlay. We're going to click on the bucket again. And we are going back to a black. And we are going to fill it up with black. Look. Now we have a completely different coloring. And we are going to lower the level. I still don't know how to call the blooding. This thing. And slide it down until you think, what shall we do? And just a little bit. That is perfectly fine for now, I think. We do not want it to be too dark. But for now, we have a little bit more shading in our... this is when it is gone. Now we have some more depth in it. And I think it looks really good. And let's go back. We're going to add on another layer. And we are going to place some more. We are going back to the fur. Shall we use the fur brush again? Yes, let's do so. Let's find him again. I think it was above here. Where it is. Almost there. Yes, we are here again. This one was the one he had, the straight fur brush. We are going to enlarge it again. Click it open. See how it's stand. 80 is, I think, right. And let's go for another color. What shall we do? Let's give him a hint of orange in some places. Would it be nice? Could be. And let's see what is going to happen. I just go and add some color on the darker part. Only there. I will find some areas like I will do with my color pencil. And I am adding on a little bit more color. Just a little bit underneath here. And here. And you can do that here. Small here. This falls underneath. I think it's going to look pretty. Just a hint of extra color. A little bit of orangey. You can do the same here. And here. A little bit of a foxy color. It's a fantasy animal. You could make him blue or whatever. It's your animal. You can give him any color you want. So just a little bit, play with it just like you would do with your pencil. Lots and lots of colors together in darker ones and lighter ones, and make a nice mixture of colors. We are going to take another layer and could use some, let's see, no yellow, it's going to be ugly. Maybe a little bit, so we'll use some, nah, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use some, I don't know, I'm doubting a little bit on what to do. I can add on a little bit of this on some places, but I think actually it already looks pretty good. I think he's handsome. He's a cute guy. The entire book is kind of cute. It's filled with these adorable creatures. They're not so complicated to color, but they are giving great effect. I do not like that. So you see, it's too yellowish what I'm doing now. I'm getting it away. I was putting a too light color on a too dark place. That's not pretty. Let's use it again, but on a different spot. Okay. Well, I think he looks really handsome. Let's do some more on the jacket. That can use a little bit more of a, yeah, a little bit more extra. What shall we do? We have this color. It's pretty, it's a duller color. And let's go to the airbrush again. Although it went pretty fine with the fur brush, so. Okay, let's see what's going to happen when we are going to do this. Are we actually seeing what's happening? Yes, it's getting it a little bit more grayish, you see. A little bit more. It tones the color a little bit down. Do I like it? No, in this case I do not like it. We are going to throw it away. We're going to make another layer and we do it all over again. You see how easy it is when you are actually not liking it. You can simply get it away. I have chosen this color. It's a little bit of a different green. I'm going to go over the folds, only over the folds and the lightest parts, and I've given it a little bit more extra. You see how pretty? A little bit of an extra color just over the lighter areas. I'm going to mix it in with my existing colors. I like it, the effect. I can tone it down. Now it's gone. Now it's a little bit, just a little bit less. And I think it looks pretty. We're going to do the same with the, with the blouse. Yes, we can do that. We are going back to the blue, and I have a grayish blue now to darken up the darkest areas, simply going over it, staying away from the light ones, and give it some more depth. That's all we are doing. Look how pretty. We're going to try to make his head a little bit darker. Go back to the color again and back to black. And let's go up to 80 and give it a little more extra. Try to get it as dark as possible. If it's possible to get it a little bit more. I like the grayish color, but I want to have some more. You can also set this to darken. That you can do that. You can also select your blending mode there. It's sometimes help you to do this and make it a little bit more darker. Not so much, but a bit. Let's see what haven't we colored yet. the plate on the inside. Let's use a, it's still on darken, you see, but it works. We make it a little bit brighter. And now let's go for the metal. When I'm doing metal, it's already a little bit copperish, so I think that is perfect. I'm going to set it to glow. And I'm going to find a color which I think that will look pretty nice as a shine to it. Let's see, what are we going to choose? I think one of those. Let's go for a color like this. And we are going to set it to enlarge. And we are doing this a little bit smaller. And I'm just adding on some metal shine. I'm toning this a little bit down, otherwise it's too much. Play with it. Sometimes you need only a little. And I am going over the parts that are light already. Now that doesn't get really smooth. I've seen, I forgot some parts. Going over this and just emphasize those light areas and get some shine to it. Now you can see we haven't done much, but it looks really metally. I call it here a little bit over the edges, so I'm correcting it. You see, it also helps doing the same here, going over the parts and get that real nice metal glow on my steampunk guy. This is so fun. You can use glow on lipstick, in eyes, on clothes. I always love to play with it because it looks really awesome and it looks really like metal. I'm going to set it smaller here and I'm going to use it on this here also, some shine on those thingies, on those metal thingies. Can we also use it on the buttons? Let's see what's going to happen if we do so. Yes, we got green shiny buttons now and blue shiny buttons. Just a little shine is so pretty. We could have given them another color. It was also possible, but we can also keep it in the color we have now. Let's see, let's straighten you out. Oh. Yeah, now, it's sometimes so complicated to get it right. I think he looks pretty nice. We can try to use another overlay. I am going to use another one. I'm going to go for color again. And let's see what's going to happen if we are going to use a dark brown. That's sometimes very pretty too. So, wrong layer. You see, I set it to color. I wanted to have to overlay. This is a brown layer. And that's really nice too. It gives it a little bit of the vintage look. You see, without, we have this. And now we give it some more warmth. I think our cute steampunk guy, sorry for, well, I think he's ready. This was a relatively simple coloring, but it's a nice one, so I hope I made it clear for you. And yeah, if you have questions, you want to see something else, just ask and I can make a new one for you. Okay, I will get the file on my computer. It's also an important thing. You always save a copy. Otherwise, you lose your Grayscale page, your original. You do not want that. If you are opening it, you see you have a TIFF file. A TIFF file you can use again. Then you have still all your layers, so you can go on and finish your painting later on. But if you think, well, it's done, then you can choose PNG or JPEG, and you can save it to your computer. Now you cannot change anything anymore, because now we have merged all the layers. So I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching, and yeah, I hope you can make sense of it.